Wendy's has proven to be one of the biggest fast food chains in the world, first known for its unusual square beef patties made from fresh ingredients. The quick service restaurant, or QSR, has expanded its menu offerings with a breakfast menu earlier this year, which has successfully boosted sales in the US. The brand is also known for its innovative solutions, starting with their very own pickup window from as early as the 1970s. Thus, it comes as no surprise that Wendy's has jumped onto the bandwagon to make its services more digitized in today's age of technological advancements, from the usage of social media strategies to implementing self-ordered kiosks in their outlets. Wendy's is able to stay as one of the top 10 restaurants in the QSR space by staying relevant to their customers. Read on as we delve further into the fast food chain's success and how it is able to thrive despite the coronavirus pandemic. In this day and age, social media is ubiquitous, giving businesses a unique opportunity to connect with their customers digitally and a platform to put their brand out there. Ever came across Wendy's Twitter account or their tongue-in-cheek tweets? Whether it's directed towards their followers or competitors, the team behind it is constantly roasting people to build their social media presence. And for good reason. This gives a sassy voice to their iconic red-haired girl icon, which definitely garners a lot of attention because of its unconventional way of speech. According to Kurt Kane, Chief Concept and Marketing Officer at Wendy's, this is their way of cultivating authentic and real connections with their followers so that they're able to know more about the brand. In addition to that, Wendy's is rocking the Twitter scene with its high organic engagement by replying to 20,000 tweets in an average of 15 minutes. In fact, a reply to a Twitter user asking Wendy's how many retweets he should get for a year of free chicken nuggets captured so much attention that eventually the user's tweet received 3.3 million retweets. The highest number of retweets at that point in time. Thanks to that, Wendy's account also gained a whopping 970,000 new Twitter followers. With a strategy that brings out outstanding statistics, it is no wonder that the fast food chain was awarded Fast Company's Most Innovative in the Social Media category in 2019. Wendy's recognizes the importance of using social media in modern-day marketing and has allowed the brand to reach new heights as they continuously receive awareness through their social media antics. And as more people show interest in them, only one thing's for sure. They certainly are doing it right. As more individuals are spending their time online, it is more important to go where the demand is. That is exactly what Wendy's is doing. Brandon Roten, Vice President for Digital and Social Media for Wendy's, said that the company recognized how the digital space can play a huge part in bringing in customers into their restaurants. That is why in 2019, Wendy's decided to set aside a budget of $25 million for the company's digital transformation, broken down into two parts. $15 million for a partnership with consulting company Accenture, and the remaining $10 million on digital scanners in the US chains. This move seeks to improve their consumer insights while giving the brand a chance to leverage its digital initiatives in the long run. Though this investment decision was made just last year, this does not mean that Wendy's store operations were primitive before. The fast food chain has implemented various digital initiatives such as mobile ordering and self-service kiosks in their stores, among others, to keep up with the latest QSR trends. They even utilized Google Preferred and TrueView to achieve the optimal audience and timing for their advertisements on YouTube, as they knew that breaking through the audiences of the new media requires a different set of requirements than that of traditional media. Additionally, Wendy's built a tech innovation center in 2015 solely for the purpose of building the Wendy's of the future, the 90 Degrees Lab. The lab focuses on improving the brand's website apps and self-order kiosks to ensure that their customers' needs are consistently met with evolving technology, all in the name of improving their customer experience. By focusing their efforts on digitization and consistently innovating, Wendy's is able to stay relevant and fulfill their consumers' changing needs. It is worthy to note that while a digital transformation is imperative, Wendy's also acknowledges the importance of staying true to its roots. That is by focusing on their quality of food, offering great value and service to customers while constantly improving their restaurants. The same mission founder Dave Thomas had when he opened his first Wendy's outlet. The pandemic crisis that hit the world earlier this year brought about much panic and precariousness in the country, leading to changes in consumers' habits, tastes, and preferences. For one, commuting to the office is minimized to reduce the risk of human contact. Naturally, this results in less drive-through breakfast or even purchase of the morning meal in general, affecting the likes of major fast food restaurants such as McDonald's and Taco Bell. However, Wendy's is the only one to buck the trend. Despite launching their breakfast items right before the lockdowns began, 7% of their sales belong to their breakfast menu, which added about 6.5% to its US same-store sales growth of 6.6% in its third quarter. This is a major feat for the fast food chain, which has never excelled in the breakfast space. The unexpected success of the launch could be attributed to Wendy's decision to revise their breakfast strategy by reducing marketing and manpower needed during the morning shifts. Wendy's way of adapting to the new COVID-19 world plays a huge role in them being able to stay afloat and even thrive. Despite the despondent circumstances of the pandemic, needless to say, in order to succeed even in the worst of times, it is important for a company to easily adjust its strategies when an unforeseen event strikes. The recipe for Wendy's success in the QSR industry is a cumulative effort of the brand's adaptive strategies, as seen from their digitization efforts and changes in breakfast menu operations during the pandemic. If you are a QSR franchise owner yourself, consider emulating their ways, and you might just find yourself catching up to the big players in the market. Wendy's recognized Twitter as the ideal platform for bringing its brand to life, but no one could have predicted the amount of attention their account would garner. Its playful persona helped Wendy's snag the number one spot on Fast Company's 2020 Most Innovative Companies list in the social media category. Wendy's tweets are engaging, clever, and at times, laugh-out-loud funny. As it turns out, likes, laughs, and retweets translates to tangible results. Wendy's reports 6 consecutive years of same-store sales growth, which Kane says is a rarity in the QSR space. Based on brand equity metrics, Wendy's is healthier than it has been in a long time. Its Twitter reputation also helps employee morale. It also takes a special culture to pull off social media stardom. That culture underpins every aspect of the business. Wendy's manages 24/7 engagement with a core team of 5 social media staffers, empowered to make quick decisions. Kane sees flat decision-making as essential to Wendy's ability to outpace competitors and continue to innovate, particularly in the delivery space. Here, Wendy's partners with DoorDash because of its focus on quality. The company also recently announced partnership with Accenture to turbocharge its work in the mobile and digital ordering space. Kane says the brand's success in social media gives the team confidence that they will excel in all digital initiatives. But don't let the roasting fool you. Wendy's fame hasn't gone to her head. The team knows it's no small feat to build a big brand that people root for. It takes confidence, culture, and deep roots. The company abides by these same guiding principles it honored 50 years ago. While Dave Thomas, founder of Wendy's, couldn't tweet about it then, innovation has always been at the heart of Wendy's business. Twitter just gave her a megaphone. People are eating at home more, but Wendy says they're still showing up for breakfast. The chain recently said that sales at its US restaurants, open at least a year, grew 2% in 2020. Thanks in large part to breakfast. CEO Todd Penegor said during an analyst call that in the last 3 months of the year, the meal accounted for about 7% of the chain's sales, and should rise to 10% by the end of 2020. Before the pandemic, competition in breakfast was heating up. Fast food restaurants saw it as a rare opportunity for growth, but once stay-at-home orders set in and many people stopped commuting to work, breakfast sales fell off. Wendy's success at breakfast can be partially attributed to the chain's huge breakfast marketing push shortly before the pandemic shut down parts of the United States last year, leaving Wendy's top of mind for customers. And people who ate at Wendy's during the pandemic have been satisfied. Wendy's breakfast menu has several options, including egg and cheese sandwiches, on croissants or biscuits, seasoned potatoes, and even some chicken sandwiches, such as the honey butter chicken biscuit sandwiches. Those fun and indulgent items may be another reason for the good sales performance during the pandemic. Not only are they really appealing to young customers, but just giving people something to get excited about, something new to try. Restaurants that sell items people can't make at home for themselves have a better chance of luring breakfast customers during the pandemic. Wendy's plans to maintain its momentum by investing more into marketing efforts. It's also expecting some people to treat its breakfast items as a mid-morning snack, which offers another sales opportunity. And once people start commuting again, breakfast sales will naturally pick up even more. When it comes to international growth, here's what they said on their website. New market expansion and further development within existing markets will continue to be dominant drivers of Wendy's worldwide strategy over the coming years. Ultimately, we believe that earnings generated from international markets will be a significant component of our ability to generate long-term value for our stockholders. With our superior quality ingredients, unique menu offerings, contemporary restaurant designs, and flexible approach to developing new markets, we believe that Wendy's is meaningfully differentiated and well-positioned for future growth. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to leave a like and feel free to subscribe to stay updated with our future videos. Thanks for watching.